गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो दिस इज़ द लास्ट यूनिट, अमेंडमेंट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, पावर एंड प्रोसीजर एंड द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन विल बी डीलिंग विद इट. स्टार्टिंग विद द बेसिक, द लार्जेस्ट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन द वर्ल्ड, आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज द लार्जेस्ट. But despite being so comprehensive, the reason why this document is so interesting is due to the fact that it is extremely flexible. Now, what do we mean over here? Flexible, that is, we can amend it anytime, right? So, in this unit, we will be doing about amendment. Now, what do we mean by amendment? It is a change, and a minor change. It could be a minor change or a change or addition to something, or even you're removing. So amendment is a minor change, you know, text. Now the father of our constitution made it so, read it, they wished that the constitution would not only aid the country to grow, but it would also grow alongside it. Thus, the government can amend the constitution depending on various issues brought up. So, the government has given a power to amend the constitution. And this power is given under 368. Article 368, which specifically says about power of parliament to amend the constitution and procedure. 368 clause first says that parliament may exercise its constituent power to amend by way of addition, by adding something, variation, or repeal, by removing something, any provision of this constitution, with the procedure, as per the procedure laid down in Article 368. So the parliament has got this power, constituent power, to amend either by way of adding, variation, or repeal of any provision of the constitution, right? Now, what is a procedure of the constitution? As it says, now, Article 368 lays down the process by which Parliament can amend the Constitution. Now, the process is that the bill is introduced in either house of the Parliament. So, the Constituent Amendment Bill, it can be introduced in any of the house of the Parliament. But a bill for this purpose of amendment of Constitution, it cannot be introduced in any state legislature. We are not talking about the state legislature. We are saying a constitution amendment bill. It can only be introduced in any of the House of Parliament. House of Parliament. Then the bill is introduced in either of the House of Parliament. The bill must be passed by total majority, and by a majority not less than 2/3 of people present and voting by both the house. So again, a constitution amendment bill, it must be passed in both the house separately by absolute plus special majority. Right? A total majority and a special majority. Specifically says 368 clause 2, when the bill is passed in each house of by a majority of total membership of that house and by a majority of not less than 2/3 of members of that house present and voting, it shall be presented to the president, who shall give his assent to the bill, and then the constitution shall stand amended in accordance with the terms of the bill.
Then, what is the procedure? After acquiring the majority, the bill is presented to the president as said. He will be giving the assent and then it is so. Then, in case of amendment of provision mentioned in Article 368, it needs to be ratified by not less than half of the states. So, ratification process. Amendment. It shall also require to be ratified by the legislature of not less than one half of the states. So it has to be ratified by them. The ratification, it should be done by a resolution passed by the state legislature. However, this must be passed before the amendment bill is presented to the president for his assent. Right? Now, moving on to understanding. Before this amendment, as we have understood, you can bring a change into your constitution by either adding or repealing anything. There arises so many questions. Whether you can amend the whole constitution? Is there any restrictions to it? Is there any limitations? Then in further, we will be understanding whether you can amend a fundamental right, whether you cannot. And there are so many cases involved into this procedure. Now starting with whether you can amend the fundamental right. And what is the basic structure doctrine? Right? So, let us start with the basic structure doctrine, which says a basic structure, this term is not mentioned anywhere in Indian Constitution. But what does it say? So, as written, the idea that the parliament cannot introduce laws that would amend the basic structure of constitution evolved gradually over time in many cases. Now this basic structure doctrine, it was brought into the limelight in the case of Keshav Nanda Bharti. This case is a landmark case for basic structure doctrine, Keshav Nanda Bharti case. Here it is written, it was Keshav Nanda Bharti that brought this doctrine into the limelight. It held that basic structure of the constitution could not be abrogated even by a constitutional amendment. So it says a basic structure of the constitution was laid down by the Supreme Court, which says that you cannot amend the basic structure. You cannot abrogate it even by the constitutional amendment. Many things were put into the basic structure of this constitution. Now what are these? Supremacy of constitution, then unity and sovereignty of India, democratic and republican form of government, federal character of the constitution, secular character of constitution, then separation of power, individual freedom. Then over the time there were many things other also added in the basic structure feature like rule of law, judicial review, parliamentary system, rule of equality, harmony and balance between the fundamental rights and DPSP, power of Supreme Court under Article 32, 136, and so many things. So if there is any law or any amendment that would violate these principles, the basic structure doctrine, the whatever is laid down into it, if any law or any amendment that violates it, it can be struck down by the Supreme Court on the ground that they distort the basic structure of the Constitution. Now, for understanding further, we need to understand how it got evolved. What is the evolution of this basic structure concept? First, here it is written. The judgment listed some basic structure of the Constitution, supremacy of Constitution. The Constitution will be supreme. Then unity and sovereignty of the India, democratic and republican form of government, federal character, secular, all of these. Now, evolution, we have to understand the evolution of basic structure concept, starting with the case of Shankri Prasad case in 1951. Now, what did the court lay in this case? It simply said, in this case, Supreme Court contended that Parliament's power of amending the Constitution under 368 included the power to amend the fundamental right. Now, in this first case, Supreme Court said that Parliament have the power to amend the fundamental right given under Part 3rd, but then further moving on to the Sajjan Singh case. So first you understand, we are here seeing how did this basic structure concept came. So there were questions on to putting fundamental right into whether there were so many questions about can we amend the fundamental right or not. So in this case, Shankri Prasad, Supreme Court said that Parliament under Article 368 includes the power to amend the fundamental right. But then in Sajjan Singh case, in this case also Supreme Court held that Parliament can amend any part of the Constitution including the fundamental right. Now, moving on to the Golaknath case. In this case, court reverses earlier stance that fundamental right can be amended. Then Golaknath case is an extreme important case. It said that fundamental rights are not amendable. So in both two cases, in Shankri Prasad and Sajjan Singh case, Supreme Court continues saying that fundamental rights can also be amended. But then in Golaknath case, it said fundamental rights are not amenable to the parliamentary restriction as stated in under Article 13. And that to amend the fundamental right, a new constituent assembly would be required. And it also stated that Article 368 gives the procedure to amend the Constitution but does not confer on Parliament the power to amend the law. So just gives a procedure to amend the Constitution. So in this case, this case conferred upon fundamental right a transcendental position. Then moving on to the landmark case of Keshav Nanda Bharti. The landmark case in defining the concept of basic structure doctrine. Supreme Court held that although no part of the Constitution, including fundamental right, was beyond the Parliament amending power, basic structure of Constitution could not be abrogated even by constitutional amendment. And the judgment implied that Parliament can only amend the Constitution and not rewrite it.
and the power to amend is not a power to destroy. It was also held that this is the basis in Indian law in which judiciary can strike down any amendment which is passed by the parliament that is in conflict with the basic structure of constitution. Right? Now moving on to the other case. Indira Nehru Gandhi versus Raj Narayan case. What happened in it? Here, Supreme Court applied the theory of basic structure and struck down the clause 4 of 329A, which got inserted by 39th Amendment in 1975. On the ground that it was beyond the Parliament power. Amending power as it destroyed the constitution basic feature. So this 39th Amendment Act, it was passed by the Parliament during the emergency period, and this act placed the election of the President, the Vice President, the Prime Minister and Speaker of the Lok Sabha beyond the scrutiny of the judiciary. So as we know, the case that we have discussed in the previous one, in 1971, Raj Narayan, he contended against Indira Gandhi. Raj Narayan filed a petition to appeal to the Allahabad High Court for using, he blamed Mrs. Gandhi for using unfair means to win the election, and Allahabad High Court held her to be guilty of election malpractice, and it was held that she could not stand in election in constituency for 6 years. Aggrieved to this, what did Indira Gandhi did? She moved to the Supreme Court, but because Supreme Court was on vacation, so Indira Gandhi called for an emergency. Now emergency was declared due to internal emergencies, with the ground of internal emergency. But in reality, the real reason was the judgment of Allahabad High Court. Now, the Supreme Court tried to stop this order and shift the deliberation against it to a future date. But Parliament added Article 329A to the 39th Constitution Amendment Act 1975, which made such matters out of the jurisdiction of the court. And therefore, 39th Constitution Amendment Act 1975 was challenged in a court. Now, Clause 4 of Article 329A, it stated that election of Prime Minister or Speaker of House of People would not be questioned by any authority other than the ones mentioned in the law made by the Parliament. It also stated that the validity of such law will not be questioned by the courts. Right? So then the issue which came upon was that is the 39th Constitution Amendment Act constitutionally valid? It was held. The court upheld the ratio of Keshav Nanda Bharti case and stated that Clause 4 of Article 329 as unconstitutional.
and the majority bench stated that a free and fair election is a basic part. It is a part of basic structure of constitution. And if you are taking away that, then that is a huge infringement of their right. And it is also violative of the basic feature of constitution. Right? So, well understood about this case and what was held under Keshav Nanda Bharti. The 39th Amendment Act was passed by Parliament during emergency period. Then this act placed the election of President, Vice President, Prime Minister and Speaker of Lok Sabha beyond the scrutiny of judiciary. Now moving on to with the Minerva Mills Limited case. In this case, the court examined the implication of government being able to amend the article in constitution, which gave them the power to amend. In this case, relationship between directive principle and fundamental right were also examined. The constitution makes it clear that the constitution and not the parliament is supreme. It made it clear that constitution is supreme. So the case strengthened the basic structure doctrine. The court added two feature to the list of basic feature, structure feature, that was judicial review and a balance between fundamental right and BBSP. Then there comes Vaman Rao case. In this case, the ratio of Minerva Mills Limited was reversed, and it cleared many doubts in Keshav Nanda Bharti case, such as the validity of the act passed before the judgment. In this again, the Article 31A was in question. Article 31B, 31C. Then came the case of Indira Swani versus and Union of India. Supreme Court examined the scope and extent of Article 16.4 into it. Now what was 16.4? It provides for the reservation of jobs in favor of backward classes. And it upheld the constitutional validity of 27% reservation for OBC. So rule of law was added to the list of basic feature of constitution in the case. Then SR Bommai case, Supreme Court tried to curb the blatant misuse of Article 356. We have done it in emergency. The concept of basic doctrine was applied into it. So that's it about the case. All of these cases which showed that how basic structure doctrine was evolved and how landmark case Keshav Nanda Bharti how important it is. If I can sum it up and tell you, each and every case over here is important, starting with what all we have done. We have understood what is amendment, then what is the basic structure doctrine, what is the idea, and Keshav Nanda Bharti case brought this doctrine into limelight. These principles were laid down into it, like supremacy of constitution, unity, sovereignty, separation of power, individual freedom, secular character, federal character, rule of law, judicial review. Further, it has been amended many times. Then its evolution from Sankari Prasad case, which in this case Supreme Court contended
fundamental right can also be amended. Then in Sajjan case, Singh case, the same thing was held. In Golaknath case, court reversed its earlier stance that fundamental rights can be amended. The court said that it cannot be amended. Then came Keshav Nanda Bharti case, where Supreme Court held that although no part of constitution, including fundamental right, was beyond parliament amending power, basic structure of constitution cannot be abrogated, even by a constitutional amendment. Then came the Indira Nehru Gandhi case, where Supreme Court applied the theory of basic structure and it struck down clause 4 of 329A. As 39th Amendment Act was passed during Parliament by Parliament during the emergency period, and the Act placed election of President, Vice President and Prime Minister and all beyond the scrutiny of judiciary. So this was done by the government in order to suppress Indira Gandhi's prosecution by Allahabad High Court for corrupt electoral practices. Then came the Minerva Mill case. This case again strengthened the basic structure doctrine. So judges ruled in this case that a limited amending power itself is a basic feature of the constitution. Then Vaman Rao case. In this case again Supreme Court reiterated the basic structure doctrine. Then the second point is also important. It also drew a line of demarcation as April 24, 1973, that is the date of Keshav Nanda Bharti judgment, and held that it should not be applied retrospectively to reopen the validity of any amendment. So therefore, this is important on this point. And in Keshav Nanda Bharti case, petitioner had challenged the Constitution 29th Amendment Act, which placed the Kerala Land Reform Act 1963 and its Amending Act, 9th Schedule of the Constitution. Now, this 9th schedule was added to the Constitution, First Amendment Act, with the Article 31B, which provided protection to the land reform laws, which was made by the state. Now, this was done in order to prevent them from being challenged in a court. Then Article 32 says, the state shall not make any law inconsistent with fundamental right. And if any law is made in controversial or fundamental right, it shall be void. Now Article 31B, it protects law from 13.2. So laws enacted under it are placed in 9th schedule, which automatically gets immune to challenge in any court, even if they go against fundamental right. So in this Vaman Rao case, it was held that amendments made to the 9th schedule until the Keshav Nanda Bharti judgment are valid, and those passed after the date can subject to scrutiny. So therefore, this was very important. That any case, any amendment which is made to the 9th schedule until Keshav Nanda judgment, till then they are valid. So retrospectively, it was valid. But those passed after the date, it can subject to the scrutiny. Then came the Indira Sawhney case. S.R. Bhumai case, which again talks the same. And that's it for the... this was the last part of your syllabus amendment. And yes, thank you. Which included the basic structure doctrine, its power and procedure laid down under Article 368. This is given under Part 20 of the Constitution, Amendment of Constitution. Thank you.